Hi everyone, my name is Harshita Solanki and I hope everyone is doing just fine. Today I have brought this another poem for you, and this poem is for grandmothers. I basically wrote this one for my grandma. So this thing happened, I recently shifted and I had been living with my grandmother for the past 18 years, like since when I was born. So for some reasons I had to shift. And the first time I visited her after this shifting process, I realized how much I actually missed her. Because in the past 18 years, there hadn't been a single day where I didn't see her face in the morning. She would be standing in the kitchen preparing something. And sometimes she would drop me off to the bus stop. And there are just so many memories and so many other things. So I told her that, Amma, I will be writing a poem on you, and she was too excited. She started giving me ideas, you know, click a picture of my hands and also write about this, write about that, and click the picture of all the sweaters I've made for you and all that. I was like, okay. So I wrote this poem for my grandma and the title is Amma. When she held me for the first time, her hands didn't shake back then. She dropped a tear when heard my first cry, a cub was born in a lioness den. I visited her after 2 long months, reached out to her wrinkled hands, dull, grey, nervous and earthy, that held tenderness of a mother and weariness of a father. I remember she used to put me to sleep at the corner of the bed, made a fort of pillows around me so I wouldn't fall and yell. She knitted beautiful sweaters of wool when powerfully skilled hands were her only tool. Pretending to be oblivious of her inevitable aging, she frowns charmingly, but I know her cheeks are aching as I felt the warmth of her precarious hands over my face. I wiped my tear that rolled down in haste. Then she hugged me tight like a little infant. Her croaky voice said, I've missed you all this time, you've been distant. She walked me down through a memories lane where she talked about her contentment and vigorous pain. I hope she lives a beautiful life, for a beloved grandma she has been and a benevolent wife. That was my poem for my grandma. I hope you liked it. I would just like to add that the least we can do for our grandparents is to give them a little time out of our busy lives. That is something that makes them really happy. Whatever you do for them, they'll appreciate it. So make them proud, make them happy. And now I'll see you with another poem. And until then, take care, stay safe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.